And there are many others whom I was listening to singing praises of Weta, 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 Mheshimiwa, Papa Roma. What is that that lies behind you that makes you a darling of the Kenyans?
I have been in Parliament from 1993. I went to Parliament when I was very young. And I've, through my journey in politics and public life, endeared myself to my people. Pay fees for people. Help them with their social requirements. I help them to deal with their personal issues, public issues, construction of schools, health centers. But above all, I'm available to them. You can see my gates are open. From 6 in the morning, my gate is open. Whoever wants to come to see me, they don't need an appointment. They come and see me. Last elections, for your information, they elected me without my printing a poster, putting up a billboard, having any t-shirt, any cap, anything that you call campaign paraphernalia. I had nothing. These people you see were saying, the poster of Papa Aroma is in our hearts.
And now this brings us to the biggest conflict that has rocked Uganda and Kenya, and that is Migingo Island. What steps have you taken to ensure that these communities survive harmoniously on that island?
It is true that Lake Victoria is a shared resource. It is equally true that the largest part of the lake is shared between Tanzania and Uganda. Kenya, we only have about 5% of Lake Victoria, if not slightly less. But it's also true that Migingo Island and a series of other islands in Lake Victoria have been a source of friction between Kenya and Uganda. These issues erupted when I was foreign minister, and together with my brother Sam Kutesa, who was then my counterpart, President Kibaki and President Museveni gave us a direction to organize for an international survey of our existing colonial boundary based on available records. And I can tell you that the survey showed very clearly that Migingo Island is in Kenya. It's Kenyan territory. Why it continues being an issue, I don't understand. Why we should even quarrel over a half an acre of land in Lake Victoria, I don't understand. It's a shared resource. It is a resource that is God-given. Yes. What I expect Kenya and Uganda to do is within the context of the East African community. We have said we want to move to federation. When we federate, boundaries will be irrelevant. If boundaries are irrelevant, nobody will talk about Migingo. And that is the answer to it. The regrettable thing is that Uganda, as a neighbor, has very active lake management structures, including security, coast guards, and so on. Once in a while, they harass Kenyan fishermen, arrest them. 10 kilometers from the Kenyan frontier, they are taken all the way to Entebbe, to Kampala, Jinja, and that causes a lot of disquiet among members of communities around the lake. This is something that through the Ministries of Foreign Affairs, through the protocols of the East African community, and personal conduct between the heads of state, it can be resolved. I know for a fact that President William Ruto, our president of Kenya, is a close friend of President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni of Uganda. And I'm sure that they will be, and those of us who speak to them and advise them will encourage them, that at their level as the sovereign authorities in our two countries, they should bring this matter to a closure once and for all.
Back to the political arena. In Africa, we exercise a democracy which says the winner takes it all. And now, when you took over power, when you were elected, it's like the people of Odinga and then the Azimio team have lost it all. You as a new government, are there any steps you've put across to ensure that you harmonize, you engage all these people in the development of the country?
When you finish elections, my encouragement is that those who have not won should form a strong opposition to oversight those who are in government. Because a government that doesn't have an oversight and an opposition in check can also become wrong.
Yes.
So I do not advocate in this handshake business like the one President Uhuru had with Raila, because it is an affront to democracy. It's an antithesis of democracy.
Yes.
Democracy is, there is two sides to every political contest. At the end of the day, one side wins, the other doesn't. You wait for 5 years, you go to elections, the tables may change. Another side could win, another side could lose. What is important is how do you institutionalize structures that ensure that even those who are in opposition are respected of our country and they play their role, but they have no duty and no business to usurp authority and responsibilities of government without a mandate.